Hey, Derek. Right here. Can you just, it's been a little bit since the fight ended. Can you just give us some reflections on how you felt things unfolded tonight?
I don't understand why y'all asked me questions after I lost.
Why are you here? Do you not feel like speaking to us tonight, or?
Nah.
Is there anything you want to address at all?
Shit, he did what we thought he was gonna do. He was gonna wrestle. Shit, point blank. You know, I was feeling good in the second round, throwing, had a good movement going, and shit, he just went for the takedown.
What was the game plan for you? Was it to hopefully be able to stop those takedowns and just land the big shot?
Yes, for sure. Really, in the third round, we thought we had the upper hand to really finish the fight in the third. And my breathing was good. Everything was good. You know, we just had to wait until the third round to really turn it on.
What did Daniel say to you after the fight? It looks like you guys, you know, exchanged some words in the cage.
He just said, keep my head up, basically, and just keep going. I'll be back.
And how do you feel right at this moment about your future? You've obviously been, you know, super active in the past few years, the most active heavyweight on the roster. Are you looking forward to some time off now?
Yeah, for sure. Hopefully I don't have to fight no more this year. Get some time off, then they can hit me up before the summer and next year.
Just last thing. Obviously, you took this fight very short notice. You had a tough fight a few weeks ago. You said all the right things leading up to it, but are you able to reveal now how, you know, were you in the shape that you said you were in leading into this fight? Were you as healthy as you, you know, were saying pre-fight?
Yeah, I was pretty good. Nothing was hurting. My conditioning was there. Probably like one of the best shapes I've ever been in, physically and mentally, really.
Derek, just when you look back, do you think that maybe you wish you had some more time to prepare for someone like DC? Obviously, he has a very high level of wrestling, you know, a full camp instead of just, you know, 4 weeks notice. You didn't even know you were having this fight until about 3 weeks ago.
Not at all. You know, I was still in good shape. You know, I've been wrestling and learning how to do wrestling defense my whole career, so it was nothing new.
He said in the post fight that you did catch him with one coming in that bothered his eye. Do you remember? You recall that one, and was there anything to kind of build on from there? Do you think for you?
Not really. You know, I didn't feel anything whenever I hit him. If I did hit him, I didn't feel it.
And then just the last thing, this whole experience, obviously there's a loss, but there were some gains, financial, sponsorship-wise. A good experience overall for you think?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Real quick, so obviously the goal had been obviously trying to take his head off. We'd seen in the lead-up you had a lot of good wrestling get-ups, get-ups off your back, get-up off your sides. Were you expecting that low single that he kept going after? You kept on going with the ankle pick and getting real, real low on you. Was that in the camp that you'd been working on, or did that not come up?
No, he did pretty good on that. You know, I didn't expect for him to do that. I guess that's part of the chain wrestling or something like that they call. So he did pretty good on that. He caught me off guard.
From your perspective, Derek, Daniel, he's building quite a legacy. Do you think he could be one of the greatest heavyweight fighters of all time when it's all said and done for him?
I don't know, man. Shit. We'll just see how things go, you know? Shit, this is second heavyweight fight. I don't know. Good night, man.
Thank you.